Rochelle Bear with Art Moose here at the Licensing Expo. We have a wonderful guest with us today, Betty Grace Miner.
Thank you for having me.
It's wonderful to meet you and take a look at some of your art. Is this your first time at the Licensing Expo?
Yes, it is. It's the first time exhibiting.
Welcome. I found out a little something about you. The Licensing Expo has a one-to-watch contest, and you were named one of the top 10. Is that true?
That's right.
Congratulations.
That's right. Thank you so much. It was a thrill to...
First time out of the gates.
Yes.
Getting great recognition already.
I was really, really pleased.
It's going to be a great show for you. Let's start with how you got your start in art.
Well, it's funny because I was actually working as a litigation paralegal.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's a different side of the brain, right?
But I loved art. I loved photography. I was doing photography. But my real love was doing hand-manipulated Polaroid. It's an art form that goes back to the 70s. It's a fun little process that you could just take a picture, and there's just maybe 30 seconds or so while it's developing, and the image is soft, and you can take a tool like a popsicle stick or your thumbnail. I used a knitting needle.
You
push the emulsion around and it creates like a painted kind of look. I was doing that at a jazz festival one day, just kind of poking around, and I did one of the musician that was playing and gave him a print of it. His wife went crazy over it and had me do a Christmas card for them. They sent that out to 400 people in the music industry with my name on the back. And then I suddenly was offered an exhibit. And I said, well, I've got this one image.
I've got this one. But it launched your
So I spent the next year creating images for a book and an exhibit. And it just launched everything for me.
But from the Polaroids, you've now gone into different...
Right. I so many people said, okay, Polaroid's not going to make this film forever.
Okay.
What are you going to do when they stop making it? Yeah. And I said, well, I'll probably have to learn to paint.
Okay. And so you did.
I cried for 2 months. And I said, okay, get serious.
Okay.
And I already did paint, but it was very, very abstract.
Okay.
It was more like Jackson Pollock. I would splatter. Paint on things, you know, and it was kind of a little therapy in the process.
Yeah, working out some things.
Yeah, that's right. So so that kind of got me started in the painting, and I already was a photographer, so then that kind of culminated into combining the two things. So I found Corel Painter. It's a computer program, but it's not a push a button, make a painting.
Okay.
You have to know how to paint. It's every single stroke is hand done.
Okay, well, I want to see this fusion. Let's get started and take a look at some of these images you brought with us today.
Thank you.
And so this is you make it with the computer and with paint, or is it all the painting?
It's a combination. I start with a photograph that I do.
Okay, so this was started
like
with a photograph.
The four friends, the four bottles of wine, right? I started with a photograph. Then I scanned it, brought that image into Corel Painter.
Okay.
And basically it's like putting a piece of tracing paper over a photograph. Mm. So you can see the image behind.
Okay.
And then you sort of, then you paint. I kind of use it as a drawing.
Okay.
Because I can't draw.
Ah.
If I draw a stick figure, I'm doing very good.
Okay, but this is gorgeous. So obviously you're doing something right. Let's take a look at you've got vibrant colors.
I love color. I had a teacher once that told me, and I can't do a British accent, but he was very British, and he said, Betty, you mustn't be afraid of color.
Oh.
And I said, sir, color should be afraid of me.
That is a good one.
And that's sort of my motto.
Let's take a look at is this from the
From the music thing, yeah. Now, this is a painting, though. It's from a photograph that I did.
Okay.
And there's actually a full image, but I just loved that piece of it. I just love that piece of it with his hands
so
and the horn.
It's so relaxed and calming and smooth, but yet it has the groundedness of the reality since it is based on a...
Right.
And I love the flowers. I think there's more flowers.
Yeah, that's a new series that I have, and it's called Wildflowers. It's kind of a pun, you know, wildflowers, and then they're wildflowers.
Right.
You know, because I love color, and I thought, why not? Everybody does flowers, but mine are wild.
Yours are a little wild.
A little wild.
This is a new collection, correct?
This is a new collection called Through My Window.
Is this really through your window?
Well, it's not really
through
my window.
It's
through my imaginary window.
Ah.
I live in a loft in downtown LA.
Okay.
And I have 18 windows. It's 2,400 square feet and has 18 windows. And all I look at is other buildings. I don't have a view.
Ah.
So I imagine I would love that loft to be at the beach. That would be the perfect home if that loft was at the beach.
And people can get these and transplant themselves. They can look through this window instead
of there. There's all these things that I envision through my window, because I'm sort of a voyeur in this case, you know. I see all these things through my window, and it's just, it's peaceful for me.
I love this collection. I think a lot of people relate to that as well.
All right, thank you.
We got another holiday.
Yes, this is Starry Solstice.
Okay.
Which technically isn't Christmas, but...
Oh, it can be anything.
It can be anything, yeah. And I had Van Gogh in my mind. And I just started doing all these little swirls, and I just had so much fun, I didn't want to stop. So I'm going to have to do a whole series of these little swirly things.
Thank you so much for coming by.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's been Rochelle Bear with Art Moose. We'll see you soon. ¶¶